So here's what we know right now. This incident started in the Shepherd area. Apparently, a property owner interrupted a theft or a burglary, confronted two male individuals, ended up chasing them off, and then ultimately was starting to give chase in a vehicle, I believe. One of the individuals in the suspect vehicle had a weapon and fired at this property owner. I believe the windshield was hit, and I believe he was hit either with a ricochet or a direct shot. At some point in time, the sheriff's office became involved in the pursuit, and that ended up here in Billings. We were poised to assist as it came into town. The pursuit ended up in a dead-end cul-de-sac on Sahara here off of Aronson. The two suspects drove into somebody's yard, into their backyard and right up to the precipice of where the rims are. And then they bailed out of the vehicle and went down into the wooded and heavily foraged area in the rims. And so what we have right now is multiple agencies responded. We set up a perimeter, bringing resources to bear to clear that area and try to locate them. We did put out a notice through the Code Red system to local residents to lock their doors, stay inside, and that was early on, so we were able to pull that perimeter in a little bit, but we're still asking for people to watch out for anything suspicious. And right now what we have are officers that are trying to systematically work the search area down there. We'll bring whatever resources we need at this point, possibly some drone activity. You'll see if we can get some aviation support. Obviously, clearance from the airport to operate is going to be necessary. At this point, the only injury that I'm aware of would be the property or homeowner in the Shepherd area, and that's a sheriff's office case, and we're basically just assisting on the apprehension side of things. So that's what I know right now, and we'll follow up with more details that become available.
Chief, is there a description of these two?
Two really cursory descriptions that I got. Males, obviously, one possibly a native, one possibly a white. Don't have any clothing description or any other physical description of them. We do believe they're armed with a rifle. I believe that's what was used in the shooting out in the Shepherd area. So that obviously gives us great concern. Number one, the propensity to use a firearm. Number two, you know, the reach that it has and in the area that our officers are operating in. So we're proceeding with the abundance of caution, and that's why we want to make sure that all the residents are taking whatever measure to stay safe as well. We still are requesting people to stay out of the area, specifically Alkali Creek, and until we work these problems.
You just know of the one firearm at this point?
I believe just one. That's the only information that we have.
Okay.
The vehicle that they were in is stolen.
Okay.
We also believe there's a second vehicle that might be associated with it, another stolen vehicle. It's a white pickup flatbed taken out of the county. I'm not sure what the details are, and that's just, again, very early on this, trying to sort things out. Mm-hmm. There possibly was other people with them, and they didn't go down the dead end street as the others did.
Any indication at this point if there's a reason they went where they went with the vehicle, if they ditched it there for a reason, or was this just random?
No, purely conjecture on my part that they weren't familiar with the area.
Okay.
And, you know, if they pick another street, it just goes around, but that would be purely conjecture on my part.
Okay. Go ahead.
Any tips from neighbors or people saw them coming in, or...?
No, not that I know of. I think any information we would get would be somebody, you know, pointing they went that way because it was that fast out of that building. Again, relatively early in the morning, I think this is around 9 a.m. Thereabouts, and it starts coming into town. So probably not a lot of activity. And again, you're in a very quiet neighborhood in a dead end, so probably not a lot of people that are out looking around. But I have not heard any information of witnesses pointing us in the right direction. We do have a lot of people out looking around out of interest, and that's what we want to caution people, is to, you know, shelter in place and you know, let us know if they see anybody wandering around their neighborhood.
Do you have anything else you can say about the nature of... We were told earlier that the sheriff's office may have pursued the suspect vehicle into town.
Correct.
Anything else you can say about the nature of that pursuit, high speeds, any traffic accidents as a result, things like that?
No, I have no information on that. I just got it that they were chasing somebody and we were going to support them because it was involved in a shooting.
Sure.
I just assume that's a high-speed pursuit. I mean, they might have been following, but I would have to refer you to the sheriff on anything that took place out in the Shepherd area or anything that took place prior to coming into our jurisdiction.
And obviously PD and sheriff's office are working together on this one. We were told Highway Patrol was here earlier. Any other law enforcement agencies assisting right now?
Well, we have U.S. Marshals are out tracking down some leads as well. And once again, I mean, you've heard me say this before, the partnership we have with all our law enforcement entities in Yellowstone County is second to none. It's too late to build relationships when things like this happen. So it's a couple phone calls and we have a lot of help. There are a lot of resources there. And keep in mind, we've got other people that are handling the regular calls for service. Those have not stopped. So we've got command officers that are out helping to mitigate some of those things too. So it's an all hands on deck right now. Hopefully we can get them located and get them resolved very quickly.
Thanks, Chief.
That's all I got.
Good? Yeah.